各位好，欢迎收看本期的《天天话题之财经专栏》。在今天的节目当中呢，我们为您邀请到的是南加州梅因美医院的高级副总裁及首席战略官 Cliff Daniels。Mr. Daniels, thank you so much for joining us today.
Well, thank you for having me.
Mr. Daniels, I know a lot of people probably don't really know about this, but your very first patient at the hospital is actually a Chinese woman. Can you give us some background history on Methodist Hospital?
Sure. The hospital was actually formed in 1903, about 118 years ago, in downtown Los Angeles, by the United Methodist Women, who recognized the need for healthcare in the community surrounded and was part of downtown LA. It was started in a two-floor, five-bedroom house, I believe. And to your point, the very first patient, interestingly enough, was a Chinese woman who needed a place to have a baby and came to the new Methodist Hospital. And the irony about that is that today, the hospital in 1957 moved to Arcadia, where we still remain today. And the dominant demographic that we serve in Arcadia is the Chinese American community. So we're very pleased to continue to do that, and that our history stems from almost the very first day we were open, and understanding the needs and providing care to the Chinese community.
And what kind of the services does Methodist Hospital offer to the community?
Methodist Hospital of Southern California is indeed a full-service hospital. Honestly, I mean, when people ask me that question, I often say we do everything but transplants. It sort of seems that way. Things that we are very good at are certainly we have an emergency room that's open for all comers. We are certified for emergency care for pediatrics, so we're good to take care for kids. We know how to do that very well. We are a STEMI receiving center, a heart attack receiving center, as designated by Los Angeles County. So we're very good at taking care of heart patients here. We're also designated and accredited as a comprehensive stroke center. So patients that are feeling symptoms of stroke are free, are feel should feel confident to come to Methodist for care as well, all through our emergency department. We still offer maternal child care. We deliver about 1,500 babies a year. We have a neonatal intensive care unit to take care of sick babies if, should that happen. And we're pretty good at orthopedic care. We have an inpatient rehab facility to take care of patients that have had strokes or back surgery. And we are very good at cancer care as well. I would tell you that we are particularly adept at women's services for GYN cancers and for colorectal surgery and for breast cancer. We've got centers of excellence in all those services. And again, almost anything. The extent of orthopedics, we do total joint replacement. We have specialists that run across the board here, from neurosurgery to vascular surgery, heart surgery. Again, the front door of the hospital is our emergency room, and we're here to be available at all times to care, provide the healthcare needs of the community.
And I understand Methodist Hospital is actually a nonprofit hospital. So what does it mean to be a nonprofit hospital?
That's a very important distinction for us too. So a nonprofit hospital, after it pays all of its expenses at the end of the year, if there's money left over, if there's profit, that's not the word you use in the nonprofit world, but if there's money left over after all the expenses are paid, all that money flows back to the hospital. It doesn't flow to some shareholder or shareholders. It doesn't flow to any parent organization that's outside the community. We use that money to reinvest in technology, in additional plant and facilities, and to ensure that we have the ability to provide the full service of healthcare to the community. And I will tell you that that doesn't always suffice to do that. What we rely on a lot is the generosity of our community to help enable us to provide the safest care and the highest quality care possible. That's really the pure mission for Methodist Hospital of Southern California. And if it wasn't for the generosity of small donors who donate, $5 or $10 or $100 a year, to large donors who have been very generous with us in one-time gifts and in endowments and annual gifts, we would not be able to acquire the expensive technology and build the facilities that we've been able to build to provide all those key services that I described earlier.
And especially during COVID, you guys received a lot of local donations from the Chinese community, right?
We very much did. I will tell you that we, although you read a lot, people read a lot about and heard a lot on the news about the shortages of personal protective equipment, masks and gloves and gowns. We did not experience that. And I would say it was not because we had some secret source that we acquired those items from, or that we had unlimited money to pay the exorbitant prices that for what was available. We were the beneficiaries of the generosity of our local community. We had people walk up to the front door and drop off a box of gloves. We had a big box outside where they could do that. We had people drop off $3, $5, or $10. And that those donations range from those small, you know, family donations to very wealthy donors who donated, I'm not exaggerating, truckloads of masks. We had one donor that donated I think it was 30,000 N95 masks for us. Another donor donated over 100,000 sets of gloves for us. And they carried us through the day. Our nurses and our staff and our patients never had to worry about patient safety or workplace safety. We, you know, learned and geared and for all the guidelines that were required under COVID to make sure people were safe. Cash donations enabled us to build a tent out front of the ER where we screened patients before they got inside to make sure that they weren't cohabited with non-COVID patients. So yeah, the generosity of the community really helps us to, again, ensure safety for everybody who comes here and to enable us to provide the highest quality and state-of-the-art care that everyone comes to expect from Methodist.
Thank you, Mr. Daniels. Let's take a break and we'll be right back.
Thank you.
休息一下进入广告，广告过后呢，我们再来继续今天的天天话题，不要离开。感谢回来，在今天的节目当中呢，我们继续为您邀请到的还是南加州梅伊美医院的高级副总裁及首席战略官 Cliff Daniels. So, Mr. Daniels, as a nonprofit, I understand that your hospital accepts charitable gifts of support. Doesn't government and private insurance cover your cost? Why do you still need philanthropy?
That's a very good question, and understand why people would ask that. Certainly we do, as we provide patient care, we're reimbursed by Medicare and Medi-Cal state agencies and by private insurance companies for providing that care. That reimbursement often doesn't even cover the cost of care. And so our goal as we operate the hospitals to use that daily reimbursement for what we, for providing services to cover the operating costs of the hospital. We count on philanthropy to enable us to acquire the technology, to be able to afford the technology and the new facilities and the ability to recruit new and train doctors. We could not do that just based on the reimbursement that we receive for providing care. No nonprofit hospital is able to do that. And so philanthropy and the generosity of our community plays a really, really key and critical role in enabling us to fulfill our mission to provide the safest care and the state-of-the-art care. As I described below.
So what does the future look like for Methodist Hospital? Are there any programs and services that you anticipate offering that aren't available at your hospital today?
Oh, absolutely. That, boy, there's a great question. A perfect segue. So we recognize the situation for an independent, unaffiliated, not-for-profit hospital in this world. We've done very well to date. But the world's changing around us. The cost of equipment, the cost of labor, the ability to recruit doctors and keep them practicing at your facility is very, very much a challenge for any independent nonprofit hospital today. And recognizing the need to be part of something bigger and a bigger system that enables us to do those things I described, we have begun the process of an affiliation with the USC Health System. Our board last week, approved the agreement that we negotiated with them. In the next 30 to 60 days, the USC board of trustees will approve that agreement as well. And then we will file the application to affiliate with the California Attorney General and the Federal Trade Commission. And we expect those approvals to come out early in 2022. And I give you all that detail because once we are affiliated, great things will happen here in the local community. It's not as though, you know, everything's going to be USC and take place downtown LA. The idea of this affiliation is to enable Methodist Hospital to provide the resources locally that any world-class facility should be able to provide. And as I said, our goal, our mission here is to always provide the safest, highest quality care, but on a local basis. And our affiliation will enable USC doctors to come to Arcadia and practice at Methodist Hospital. It'll give us some access to additional capital that will enable us to extend our footprint, extend facilities out into the eastern end of the San Gabriel Valley, and then south of us too as well, down along the I-10 corridor, providing easy to access locations where people can access all the local Methodist and Arcadia physicians, but in addition, have access to some of the super specialists that now practice at USC here locally. So those are some of the great things. And specifically, I would tell you, we're looking to invest in a hybrid operating room here at Methodist, a fancy word for a room that's going to enable us to perform less invasive procedures, complex procedures that you can't perform in a regular operating room. So heart procedures like valve replacements and our aortic repair that you normally have to go to an academic medical center down at USC to have done will be able to be done here by USC physicians. There are certain other cancers that we don't really care for a lot of patients here, lung cancers and liver cancers, head and neck cancer. We've talked with urologic cancers, talking about bringing robotic technology to Methodist. And again, the physicians at USC that are highly trained and experienced in caring for these types of patients, being able to care for them here in Arcadia. So this affiliation is very important to us, and we're hoping that it also really revs up the local philanthropy to enable us to do some of these things, you know, in preparation for the affiliation and while or after we're affiliated, enable us to acquire some of the technologies like a robot and build this hybrid room so we can accommodate the needs for the physicians, the technology and equipment needs that they can work here.
Sounds exciting. So how can our viewers help with that future vision?
There's lots of ways. Our foundation is a very robust and active foundation. We have staff over there that they can get in touch with for small gifts, for large single gifts. There's annual giving programs that they could get into. There's endowments and estate gifts that they are able to donate to the hospital as well. We have events that they can support. Our crystal ball that we call it as our major fundraising event every year. It's coming up October 9th. If you go to the methodisthospital.org website and click on the foundation tab, there's some details about that. That's a wonderful gala formal event with a very nice dinner at the Pasadena Convention Center. I think this year there's always entertainment. I think we have a cover band for Queen that's performing this year. And we also have a silent auction, live auction items, and that's a great event. That event raises upwards of $800,000 for us every year. Pandemic willing, if we keep COVID under control here, it should be a very exciting date on October 9th. Other times during the year, we host an event called the Mardi Gras at the Santa Anita Racetrack, typically, where a lot of the restaurants and local vendors come and provide food for free. Of course, there's an entry fee that you pay to raise money for. There's a silent auction there as well. So these means of supporting the hospital are critical to us, again, to continue our mission here. I guess, the other thing I would assure people of is that even with our affiliation with USC coming next year, all the money that we raise here stays in the community. It doesn't go to USC. It doesn't go to some other, it doesn't go to shareholders or some other organization. Our foundation remains independent and part of Methodist Hospital, and we'll always be supporting it for all the money that raises. So again, people need not worry about, by donating to the hospital that the money's going to flow elsewhere outside the community. We support, local community organizations, and we buy technology to extend our services with all the money that's raised at these events.
Great information. Mr. Daniels, I know you're very busy and we definitely don't want to take up too much of your time. Thank you for joining us today.
You're welcome, Annie. Happy to be a source of information for you. And anytime you need more, please call.
Thank you. 同时呢，非常感谢各位的收看，我们下期同一时间再见。
您正在收看的是凤凰卫视